Greetings. Here we are going to design a compensator using Bode plot. The question is, a unity feedback open loop transfer function g of s is equal to k by s into 1 plus 2s. For that, design a suitable compensator. Let PM equal to 40 degree and steady state error for ramp input is 0.2. First, we have to find k. For that, we are using kv and ess. Kv is equal to 1 by ess. So, ES is equal to 0.2, 1 by 0.2 equal to 5, kv is 5, and we have equation for kv, that is limit s tends to 0 equal to g of s into h of s. Here h of s is 1 because it's a unity feedback, and our transfer function is k by s into 1 plus 2s, equating that into kv. So k by s into 1 plus 2s equal to 5. While substituting s equal to 0, we get k is equal to 5. Here we have three factors, 1 by s, k and 1 by 1 plus 2s. 1 by s is an integrated factor in denominator. For that, t is 1. So omega c equal to 1 by t. So we get omega c equal to 1 radian per second. The slope is minus 20 dB per decade. For integrated factor in denominator, the slope decreases as 20 dB per decade. And the frequency range is 0.1, 1 and 10. Because 1 is our omega c, and we have to take its previous decade and the next decade. And the next factor is gain factor k. For there is no relationship between frequency and gain, so that the omega c equal to 0. Slope also it's 0 because we will get a straight line. It's a constant. Magnitude of g of j omega is 20 log of 5. 20 log of this k value. Already we have find out the k value, so 20 log of 5. That is 13.97. While we plot it, we'll get a straight line. And the next factor is 1 by 1 plus 2s. This is first order factor in denominator. So that as this is in the denominator, slope is minus 20 dB per decade. And its omega c is, it's in the form of 1 plus ts. T is 2. So omega c equal to 1 by t, 1 by 2, that is 0.5 radian per second. Its frequency ranges 0.05, 0.5 and 5. Because we got omega c as 0.5, so its previous decade is 0.05 and the next decade is 5. We are going to plot in our similar graph. First, we are taking integrator factor in denominator, that is 1 by s. Here the slope is minus 20 dB per decade. Our corner frequency is 1. Before corner frequency, it should increase 20 dB. 0.1 to 1, it is plus 20 dB. And after omega c, that is 1, it decreases as minus 20 dB per decade. 1 to 10, it decreases. Gain factor is 13.97. There is no slope, that is 0 degree. So, you are plotting a straight line for 13.97. Now, we are plotting for 1 by 1 plus 2s line. That is, the omega c is 0.5 here. Up to omega c, that's up to 0.5, the slope will be 0. From 0.05 to 0.5, the slope will be 0. And after that, it decreases minus 20 dB per decade from 0.5 to 5. And we can extend this line. We are taking corner frequencies for plotting. We have to find where the k line, 1 by s line, and the 1 by 1 plus 2s lines crosses the corresponding frequencies. For example, if we see 0.05 frequency, we have to see where, here is the k line. We have to see where the k line crosses the 0.05 frequency. Here it is crossing. This, the corresponding gain decibel is 13.9. So we are making it as 13.9. And then if we see the 1 by s line, this 1 by s line crossing the 0.05 frequency at 28, so we are making it as 28. And then if we see the 1 by 1 plus 2s line, it is not crossing anymore in 0.05, so we are making it as 0. Similarly, we have to take the values of all those frequencies. After that, we have to add up these three values for getting the overall gain. Here we are going to plot the magnitude plot, so that we are using the overall gain and omega c. For 0.05 omega c, the overall gain is 41.97. As like that, we are plotting this magnitude plot in this similar graph. We are going to plot the phase plot. It is the transfer function we have that, substituting s equal to j omega. And we got this equation, angle of g of j omega is equal to minus 90 minus tan inverse of 2 omega. First, if we take this j omega, here in j omega, b value is 1 and a value is 0. By applying tan inverse of b by a, it gives tan inverse of infinity. Tan inverse of infinity is 90 degree. Because of it is in denominator, we are using minus 90. And then minus tan inverse of 2 omega, because tan inverse of b by a, that is b is 2 and a is 1. So tan inverse of 2 omega here, minus is because of this denominator. And we have to plot the phase plot using omega c and angle of g of j omega. That is, we have to substitute the omega c values instead of omega here. And we can find these values too. Using this, we can plot phase plot with degrees. The largest value is minus 179.7, so we are taking as minus 180 here. If we plot this, we can get phase plot. After completing the Bode plot, we have to determine the phase margin of the uncompensated system. Formula for phase margin is 180 plus 5gc, so that we have to find the 5gc. You see in the graph, where the magnitude plot crosses the zero, take that point and make a line until the phase plot. In that point, the corresponding angle is the 5GC. Here it's minus 162. So the 5GC is minus 162. PM is 180 minus 162 is equal to 80. Next, we have to select the phase margin for the compensated system. Desired phase margin is what is given in the question. And the compensated system phase margin is equal to PMD plus some value. We are taking it as 5. So the total PMC is 45. Next, we have to determine new 5GC and new omega GC for the compensated system. We got PMC 45 degree. So new 5GC equal to PMC minus 180 degree. PMC is 45 degree, so 45 minus 180 degree gives minus 135 5GC. And if you see in the graph, for this corresponding 135, you have to see the omega c. It gives 5. So omega c equal to, sorry, the omega GC we got is 0.5. Next, we have to design the lag compensator. The general transfer function of lag compensator is GL of S equal to S plus 1 by T by S plus 1 by beta T. By simplifying, we will get beta into 1 plus ST by 1 plus beta ST as standard form. And we have to find beta and T value from here. Beta is the attenuation factor. A equal to 20 log beta. We have this. And for this, we have to see where the magnitude plots crosses our 5GC. Or omega GC, that is 5, it crosses here. So this corresponding decimal is 20, so that A value is 20 here. After simplifying, we'll get the beta value as 10. After that, we have to determine the value of T. So C equal to 1 by T, and 0 is equal to the 1/10 of the omega GC. So omega GC we got is 0.5. So ZC equal to 0.05. By substituting it in T equal to 1 by ZC, we got T as 20. Then we have to substitute beta and T value in GL of S, so that GL of S equal to 10 into 1 plus 20 S by 1 plus 200 S. Next, the design should be validated, so that we are making a block diagram. In first block, we have to make GL of S, the lag compensated transfer function. And in the second block, we have to make the given G of S. Here we have 10, so that for cancelling, we are using 1 by 10. The feedback is 1 here. By cascading those two blocks in the block diagram, we'll get GC of S as this. And we have to find the 5GC for this. Here, tan inverse of 20 omega minus 90 minus tan inverse of 200 omega minus tan inverse of. By substituting this new omega GC here, we'll get 5GC as 140 degree. Finally, we are finding the actual phase margin, that is 180 plus 5GC. 5GC now we got as minus 140, so that is 40 degree. Will the desired phase margin given in the question?